still out there. James Darcy is with us right now. James has done a lot of things. He's yet another. We're sick of these Brits. They're on all the time.
British invasion.
Oh, boy, oh, boy. He plays a mobster in the new comedy. And if you've been watching TV at all, I don't know if you're aware of this, the promos were all over the
place. Everywhere.
I literally flew into town last night, so I'm thrilled to hear it, but I didn't know that.
All right, it's called Let's Be Cops. Here's a clip.
The Dominicans are going to make the delivery, and you're not going to do with it until I say so. Understood? Open it.
Oh.
So? They tell me their badge numbers don't match up, which tells me one thing. They're not LAPD.
Or dead.
So, what are they? Feds, ATF, maybe a special unit.
What?
Yeah, we're black ops.
Wow.
Is that you?
Transformation.
It's amazing what little facial hair can do.
Seriously.
Oh, no. Facial hair and attitude, and you're somebody else.
Right. Right? Yeah.
So, speaking of invasions, we have been invaded by the Wayans a time or two.
Right. Yeah.
You know, one family member.
There's another major one coming after this movie. So.
Sure.
So, what was it like to be on set? I mean, it's got to be just side splitting.
It was deeply intimidating. I was very pleased I was playing the villain in this movie. I wasn't expected to say anything particularly entertaining or funny because Jake and Damon and Rob Riggle just, you honestly, you'd laugh your face off every time they'd sat down in between takes and they'd just be talking. And I would have no face left because I would have laughed it off. You know, they were insane.
So did you have to redo things because of laughter? I mean.
Well, most of the time that I was on the set, the comedy, it would turn into sort of more of an action film. The film is a great combination between this fabulous comedy and then it gets a little more serious as it goes along. And so my character provides this sort of more serious angle of it. Mm-hmm. So when I was there, they didn't get to be funny on camera. They were hysterical off camera. But they didn't get to, and occasionally I'd see them shooting the scene before I would come along. And I mean, I would think, I don't remember seeing this bit in the script. And they just make it
they
up.
Make it up.
It was brilliant.
Well,
really
the concept
brilliant.
Is two guys aren't cops.
No. So the concept of the movie is you have two guys who go to a costume party and the thing that they happen to have for reasons that are explained in the script is two cop uniforms lying around their apartment. So they go as cops and as they're leaving, a bachelorette party runs up to them and says, oh my God, one of the things on our list that we have to do this evening is we have to kiss a cop. So they start making out with the two guys, and they're like, whoa, it's pretty
like,
good to
right.
be a cop,
and
right?
And
then it kind of leads into it, and sure. It snowballs and snowballs, and they get in above their heads. Uh-huh. But I mean, it's a really, really funny film. Uh-huh. My major piece of advice is, if you're going to go and see it, don't sit behind anyone you like, because you're going to be spitting your popcorn out.
Wow.
It's genuinely hysterical.
I can see that in the review. That's excellent.
It's genuinely funny.
Did you feel that way when you got the script, or was it once it started playing out and you started seeing some of the rough cuts and things?
You know, I could see in the script. The script was really funny, and I knew Jake from New Girl, so I knew that he was hysterically funny. I didn't know until we got on the set exactly how good it would be. It sort of depended on how much freedom the director gave them, and he was terrific with everybody. So. I could tell when we were shooting it that it was going to be a really, really funny movie.
I hope these stories are true.
I hope they're true, too. Yeah, what are they?
Because they're out there, so let's see if they're true.
Okay.
You once got an audition or an interview because somebody said, get me that...
Colin.
Get me Mr. Darcy.
Mr. Darcy.
And Colin Firth had just played Mr. Darcy in Pride and Prejudice.
Yes.
And so I was sent a script for a guy who was 10 years older than me. I was 21. And I was sent a script for someone who was in their 30s.
Yeah.
And was an American, and it was a split personality. He had a washboard stomach, and I read it. I'd never done anything, and I called my agent and said,
This is
great that they're calling me
get
about
me that
this.
Darcy
Why
guy,
is it?
Right?
And it was years later I worked it out that Pride and Prejudice had just been on, and somebody had said, I want that Mr. Darcy. Get
Isn't
Mr. Darcy.
A pretty common name, though, where you come from?
No, there's me. I've never met anybody else called Darcy.
Darcy?
Yeah. There's me, and then there's actually Mr. Darcy in Pride and Prejudice.
Really?
Yeah.
Well,
I don't know any other Darcys, apart from, you know, my mom and my sister.
Another story. You're trying to get to the prestigious acting academy.
Right.
You get in.
Yeah.
Right. But you had just seen Godfather. Is this a true story?
Oh, this is depressing. It wasn't that I had got in. I had auditioned, and it had not gone well, actually. And I seem to remember leaving under a real cloud because I had, you know, messed it up so badly. And I was 17 at the time, and I went home and I watched, over the course of that weekend, the first two Godfather movies. And I remember at the end of the weekend thinking, this is why I'm not supposed to be an actor, because I can't do what's happened. I can't do that.
You're looking at Pacino, you're looking at
I'm
De Niro.
Looking at Pacino, and I'm looking at De Niro, and I'm looking at Brando, and I'm thinking, I mean, no.
You're looking at Mount
Rushmore. I can't do that.
Yeah.
And literally as the second one finished, my telephone rang at my mother's house where I was living at the time, and I picked it up, and it was the admissions officer at the college, and he said, we'd like to offer you a place. And it was everything I could do not to say, I can't come, because I just watched Godfather
you know
Part 2, and
I just
can't do that.
Brando.
Someone had put a horse
yeah.
head in their bed. That's why.
Well, hey, that Darcy guy, you were pretty good. Thanks
yeah.
for coming in.
Thank
I appreciate
much.
It.
Mr. Darcy.
Let's Be Cops opens next Wednesday.